Dear students, now we'll see experiment number 3 from System Software and Operating System Laboratory. The aim of this experiment is design, develop and implement YAC or C program to construct predictive or LL1 parsing table for the grammar rules. A gives A, B, A, B gives B, B and B gives epsilon. So actually epsilon here. So use this table to parse the sentence A B B A dollar. So here we have to write a C program, C or YAC program. We have considered C program here to construct a predictive LL1 parsing table for the grammar. The grammar rules are given. First we have to construct a predictive table for this, and after that we have to parse this given string A B B A dollar. Okay. So before we go for the program, so first we'll see how we can construct a predictive parsing table for this particular grammar. So the given grammar is A gives A B A, B gives B B bar, B gives epsilon. So for this the predictive parsing table can be constructed like this. So how this predictive parsing table is constructed? So here for this predictive parsing table, so as we know, we have two variables here, capital A and capital B. So we have written capital A and capital B here, and here we have the two terminals A and small a and small b. We cannot consider epsilon here, so we have small a and small b, and we know that the string should end with the dollar. So that's why here we the input should end with a dollar, so that's why we have taken dollar also here. So here, as per the first rule, we have A tends to A B A. Okay. So here A gives here this is nothing but capital A gives the small a. So the capital A to small a. So that's why here from capital A to small a we write this string, that is A B A. So this is first. So after that, for the second variable, that is B. So B gives B B. So here the capital B gives small b. So so the first is B, so that's why in the column capital B to small b I will write B B. Okay, so this one. So after this, so the next rule is B gives epsilon. So how to, where to write this particular thing? So there is a rule that when we have an grammar rule, that is B to epsilon, so you have to write this in the column of the follow of the first variable, that is the left hand side variable. So here in our example we have the production rule as B gives epsilon, and here the variable is B. So you should know, you have to calculate the follow of this B. So here as per this rule, so we have the B here and the follow of B will be A. So that's why this B gives epsilon is to be written in the column of small a. So that's what we have done here. So B to small, in the column of small a, we have written B gives the epsilon. So in this way the predictive parsing table can be constructed for the given grammar. Okay, so after this here they have also given the string A B B A, and they have ended this with dollar. So you have to parse this one by using this particular predictive parsing table. So in our program, here again we take the two arrays. The one is we take stack, another one we take the input. So already we have read the input. The input given in the program statement title itself, the input is A B B A, it ends with the dollar. So on the stack, initially we insert the starting the first variable, that is A, and we insert a dollar. So after this, here again we have to consult the predictive parsing table in order to parse this given string. So here you can observe, so the first symbol on the stack is capital A and the first symbol in the input is A. So you have to search for a entry here, that is capital A to small a. So here in this table, for capital A to small a, we have the entry A capital B A. So that's why in the stack this capital A is replaced with this small a capital B A. Okay. So after this, here you have to again compare the first character. So here also we have the first letter as A, here also the small a. So that's why small a get cancelled, and the remaining is capital B small a dollar, and here remaining is, after cancelling small a, we have small b a dollar. Okay, So after this again you consider the first two letters, that is here we have capital B, here we have small b. So here capital B to small b, the entry is small b capital B. So that's why this capital B is replaced with this one, that is small b capital B. So this A remains as it is. So the content on the stack becomes B, small b capital B, small a and dollar. Okay. So this remains as it is in the input. So again, here you have to compare the first character and first character. Here also we have small b, here also we have small b, both will get cancelled, and the remaining part on the stack is capital B small a dollar, and on the input we have small b small a dollar. Okay, so again you compare the first letter. So here we have capital B to small b. So for capital B to small b, the content of the table is small b capital B. So that's why again this capital B is replaced with this small b capital B, this A remains as it is. Okay, so this input remains as it is. So again this first small b gets cancelled. So the remaining is capital B small a dollar, and here we have a dollar. So now we have capital B and A. So you search for capital B to small a, the content is epsilon. So that's why in place of capital B to small a, you have to replace this B with epsilon. Epsilon means nothing. So this B will disappear, we will be remaining with only a dollar here, and here also we have a dollar. So again A and A gets cancelled. So as a result the content of stack remains dollar, and here the input is also remains dollar. Dollar means you have consumed all the input, and here at the end when we have dollar in stack and input, so this indicates so you have successfully parsed the given string, and the parsing is successful. So in this way you can construct a predictive parsing table, and you can parse the given input string by using this predictive parsing table. So now we'll see how exactly a C program can be written to perform these actions. Okay. So here already I have written a program. So let us see how this program is written. So first we have to include these header files. So first we include hash include stdio.h, after that string.h, and after that stdlib.h. So after that here we have declared an character array, a two dimensional character array, that is prod, that is production, to store the production. So already we have know the production, the production rules. So in this array, so A tends to AB, B tends to BB, and B tends to epsilon. So these things are stored. So you can see here, so the same thing I have represented here. So this is production of 3 to 15. So here in this array, so this production rules are stored in this way. So after this, the next character array is a table. So it's a three dimensional array. So it's table of 2 by 3 by 3. So this indicates we have 2, means here we have two dimensional arrays, each of size 3 by 3. So that's what I have shown here. So table of 2 by 3 by 3 means we have two dimensional arrays, each of size 3 by 3. So this is first array and this is second array. So how to access this first array? So for this first array, so the first index will be 0, and for the second array this first index will be 1. So means here in order to access this, so what will be the index values here? So this is first table, so that's why the index of this will be 0. So this is 0th row and 0th column. So that's why to access this we have the values table of 0, 0, 0. Similar to access this we have the value 0, table of 0, 0, 1. To access this we have table of 0, 0, 2, and so on. Similarly, to access the second table of this, so it will be table of 1. Okay. So for this it will be table of 1, 0, 0. This is table of 1, 0, 1. This is table of 1, 0, 2, and so on. Okay, so here whatever these values are there, so these are inserted through this particular table only. Okay, so here we have inserted table, that is A, B, A, after that null, null. So in the second table we have epsilon, DB, and null. Okay, so the same thing here we have inserted. So that's what the production table. So whatever the content I have here, so the production table, whatever the predictive parsing table we have constructed, so the same details are entered here in this particular production table. Okay, so that's what here in the in this table, not production table. Okay, so after this we have taken one more array here, and that is size of order 2 by 3, and this is also already tabulated with the values, so that is also shown here, size of 2, 3. It is also already tabulated with the initial values. So along with this, we have taken the variable n, and here we have taken actually no need to take this variable. Okay, so only n is sufficient. So after this, we take two again character arrays, s of 20 and stack of 20. So s of 20 to read the input string and stack of 20 to read to store the stack contents. So this is how you declare the variables. So after this, we have the user defined function display here. So before we see this function display, so we'll directly move to our main function. So in this main function, so again we have the variables here. So int I, j, k, row, column, flag equal to 0. So after this, initially I have to display the grammar on the screen. So for that, the heading is the grammar is, so this is displayed. Okay, so and as we saw, we have stored the grammar in the array production. So we have to just display the content of that array. So for that, we have this for I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, printf percentage s slash n production of I. So this will display that entire grammar on the screen. So that's what I think I have. Okay, I have the sample output also here. So initially this grammar will be displayed as it is on the screen. Okay, so to display this, we have this line. So each time it will be displayed on the next line. So after this, I have to display the predictive parsing table also. So the heading is predictive parsing table is, and below that we will just displaying the column headings A, B, dollar, below that one line. And after this, I have to display the predictive parsing table. Okay, so here how exactly this predictive parsing table is displayed. So here we have the for loop. So for loop starts with I equal to 0. So initially I is equal to 0. So it will check this condition whether I is equal to 0. So when I is equal to 0, what it will display? It will display simply A. So that's what you can see. So it will display this heading initially, predictive parsing table is. So below that it will display the column A, B, dollar. Below that it will display the line. And after that, here based on the value of I, here I is equal to 0. So it will display the value as A. Okay, so initially, so I will write here only. So initially I is equal to 0. Okay, so when I is equal to 0, so here print A means this A is displayed. So this A. Okay, so after this, what it will do? So as this condition is true, this else part will not be executed. So this print B will not be executed. But after this, we have this remaining part also as a part of this. So after this, what we have to do? So for j equal to 0, j less than 3, j plus plus, we have to display this, we have to execute this line. So for j equal to 0, okay, so next take j equal to 0. So when j is equal to 0, what happens? So it will display printf percentage s. So a string is to be displayed from the table of I comma j. So here I is also 0, j is also 0. So table of 0, 0 will be displayed. So what is the content of table 0, 0? So here we have table 0, 0. So table 0, 0. Table 0, 0 means table of this one is 0, this one is 0. The first value 0 means this is the first table. And here the second one is 0 means this is 0th row. Okay. We have not given the column value. Means here what it will do, from the first table, it will display the first row. Means 0th row. So as a result, it will display A, B, A. So that you can see here. So after A, it has displayed A, B, A. Okay. So after this, what it will do? So once it displays this, the value of J will be incremented by 1. So now J becomes 1. Okay. So J becomes 1 now. So when J becomes 1, so again, it will come back here. So it will display the value of, see, I remains 0 only. So it is table of 0, 1. Okay. So what is the content of table 0, 1? So table 0 means again the first table. So in this, the first column. So 0, 1 means here we have the second row, which is empty. So that's why here we don't have anything here. Okay. So similarly, again, J is incremented by 1. So J becomes, J was 1 now, no, J becomes 2. So when J becomes 2, again the condition is true. So again it will display the content of table 0, 2. So table 0, 2, what is the content here? You see, table 0 means the first row and 2 means it is the second column. Here also we don't have anything, it is empty. So that's why in the output also you can see here we have empty. Okay. So after this again j is incremented by 1. So j was 2, now j becomes 3. So when j becomes 3, this condition becomes false. So when this condition becomes false, it will complete the execution of this for loop and it will execute this printf. So printf slash n means, so whatever the content we display after this, so that should be displayed on the next line. You can see after displaying this, the next content should be displayed on the next line. So here after this, so this content will be displayed. Okay, so let us see how that content is displayed. So after this, here this is end of for. End of for means here it should come back to this, because I was initially 0, now I becomes 1. So I is incremented by 1, so I becomes 1 now. Okay, so when I is 1, again it will continue the execution. So here if I is equal to 0, this condition is false. Okay, so because I is 1, so else part is executed. Else in else we have printf b, means the b is displayed. You can see the b is displayed. Okay, so after this again it will start executing this j. Okay, so j is again initialized with 0. So initially j is 0. Okay, so here when j is equal to 0, again it will display this one, that is printf percentage s table of I comma j. What is the value of I? I is 1 now and j is 0. So table of 1 0. Okay, so what is table of 1 0 here? So what is table of 1? So as I told you, this is 3 dimensional array. So table of 0 means this one and table of 1 means this one. So it is table of 1 0. Table of 1 0 means this is table 1, and in that 0 means this is table 1's 0th row. Table 1's 0th row we have epsilon. So it will display epsilon here. Okay, so here instead of epsilon we have taken e here, because that key was not available there. Okay, so it will display epsilon here. So after this, what it will do? After doing this, it will increment the j value by 1. So j was 0, now j becomes 1. So again this line is executed. So it will display table of I is 1 only, 1, j is also 1. So table of 1 1. So what is table of 1 1? Table of 1 1 means this is table 1, and in that row 1 means it will display small b capital B. You can see after this it will display small b capital B. Okay, so after this in the next iteration it will display nothing, because in this table also here the third row is empty. So that's why when this j is incremented, j becomes 2, so table of 1 2 is empty. So as it is, it will display empty, and after this, this is the this is going to display the next line. So after this again the control will come back here. So I will be incremented by 1, now I becomes 2. So when I becomes 2, the I less than 2, the condition is false. So as a result, the execution of this for loop will be terminated. So after this it will continue to execute these remaining lines. Okay, so see here, now we have displayed the grammar, we have displayed the content of predictive parsing table also. So now we have to parse the string. So to parse the string, first we have to read the string. So for that it will display the message as enter the string. So see here, after this it will display the message as enter the string. So user is going to enter the string ABBA. Okay, so whatever the string he enters, so that we read the variable yes by using this scanf statement. So once we read the string yes, so we concatenate dollar to this yes. So along with this yes, because as per the experiment title also, we know that the given input string is ABBA dollar. So after concatenating dollar, we'll find the length of this string yes. Okay, so here the given input string is ABBA, so it is of size 4, plus dollar means the n will become 5. Okay, so that we have noted down. So after that, what we do is, so we insert stack of 0 equal to dollar and stack of 1 equal to. So that I have shown here. So we have two arrays here. So first one is yes. In this we have read the input string ABBA, and after that we have concatenated dollar. So the content of input yes is dollar. So in this stack we insert a stack of 0 equal to dollar and stack of 1 equal to A. Stack of 0 equal to dollar, stack of 1 equal to A. So after this we take I equal to 1 and j equal to 0. So we take I equal to 1 and j equal to 0. Okay. So after this here again we'll display the two headings. So one side we display the heading as stack, another side we display the heading as input, as you can see here. So one side we display the heading as stack, and after that we have to display the heading as input. And here I have to display the content of stack and content of input whenever we do the parsing. Okay. So here after displaying this, we'll display one line, and after this we have the infinite loop here, that is while. So in this while, first we'll check this, that is if stack of I is equal to s of j. So what is the value of I? I is 1 and j is 0. So we have to check whether stack of 1 equal to s of 0. So what is stack of 1? This is stack. Stack of 0 is this one. Stack of 1 is A. So what is stack of 1? Stack of 1 is capital A and s of 0 is small a. Whether capital A is equal to small a? No. This condition is false. So when this condition is false, this is first if, because we have number of if here. So that's why I have written the comment here. So when this condition is false, the first if will not be executed. Okay. So here means this particular if will not be executed. Okay. So if this if is not executed, so after that we have the switch statement here. So switch stack of I. So what is stack of I? So I is 1. So stack of I is capital A. Okay. So here as per our program, the stack of A is capital A. So case A, so row is equal to 0. This is executed. The value 0 is assigned to row. Okay. So here we'll note down that also. So here row will become 0. Okay. So after this, we have one more switch statement, that is S of J. So what is S of J? J is 0. So this is array S. So S of 0 is small a. Okay. So here when case small a, the column is equal to 0. Okay. So we note down this also. So we have column value equal to 0. Okay. So after this, we have the next line here. So if table of row column 0 equal to null. Okay. So here table of row column 0 equal to null. So here we have to check whether a table of row column 0 equal to null. So here already I have noted down as per our present this one, the row is also 0, column is also 0. So it is table of 0, 0, 0. So what is the content of table of 0, 0, 0? So table of 0 means first table. So the second 0th row, 0th column. So it is A. Okay. So here we have to check whether it is equal to null. It is not equal to null. It is A. So that's why this condition will not be this condition is false, so this is not executed. So else if whether this is equal to epsilon, this is not also equal to epsilon because this is small a, so that's why the else part is executed. So in the else part, actually this line is not required. Just a minute. Okay. So in the else part, we have again for loop for k equal to size of row column. Okay, column, it should become minus 1. So it is size of row column minus 1. So what is the value of size of row column? Row is also 0, column is also 0. So we have the array size here. Size of 0th row, 0th column, it is 3. So this value becomes size of row column, it is 3 minus 1, it is 2. So the k will start from 2. So k is initial, I will note down this also. So k is equal to 3 minus 2, it is 3 minus 1, it is 2. So k is equal to 2. Okay. So here what we have to do, so each time we have to add the values to the stack. So stack of I is what? I is 1. So stack of 1. So here in this place, so what we have to enter? So stack of 1 equal to table of row column k. Row is 0, column is 0, k is 2 here. So here row is 0, column is 0, k is 2. So table of 0, 0, 2. So table of 0, this is 0th row, and 2. 2 means this one, second column. So this is A. So as a result, we are going to add A here in place of stack, that is small a. Okay. So after this, what it will do? It will increment the value of I by 1. So I becomes 2 now. So when I becomes 2, so once again this line is executed. So k will also be decremented by 1. So it will come back here. So k is decremented by 1, k becomes 1. So again, we have to write stack of I equal to table of row column k. Okay. So now stack of I is 2 now. So this is 1. So stack of 2 is this one. So here in this place, what we have to write? We have to write table of row column K. So table of 001. So what is table of 001? So table of 0 means this is first one. So 001, this is one. That is capital B. Okay. So here in this place, we have to write capital B. Okay. So after this, again, I value will be incremented by 1. So I becomes 3 and J value will be decremented by 1. K will be decremented by 1. Now K becomes 0. Okay. So here again, this will be executed. So this time, so stack of 2. So stack of actually the value of this is 3. So stack of 3. So stack of 3 equal to 000. Okay. So table of 000 is table of 000 is small a. So as a result, here this small a will be added. Okay. So that's what the content of stack is at the beginning. So you can see here it is, we have a capital B small a. Okay. So that's what we add here. That is a capital B small a. So this I have to display on the screen now. So that's why here after this I is incremented by 1. Okay. And K will be decremented by 1. So K will become minus 1. So this condition false and the for loop will be stop execution. And after that we decrement the I value by 1. So I was 4 now. So minus 1 I becomes 3. So after this we call the display. So display of I comma J. So what is I? So I is 3 and J is 0. So we call this display function by the value of I equal to 0. value of I equal to 3 and J equal to 0. So here we take K, again K is equal to 0 here. So we initialize K equal to 0 in this display function. So here it will just display the content of stack. So what it will display? So from starting from K equal to 0 to I, it will display the content of stack. So stack of K. So K is initially 0. So stack of 0. So what is stack of 0? Stack of 0 is dollar. So first this will be displayed. So again K will be incremented by 1. So it will display A. After that it will display B. After that it will display A. So as it is, this dollar ABA is displayed on the screen. You can see dollar ABA. Dollar ABA, this is displayed on the screen. So after displaying the content of stack, we have to display the content of input on the screen. So for that we have, after this we'll display one space, because after the stack content, between stack content and input content we have one space. So here we take again K equal to J, K less than or equal to N, K plus plus, will display the content of yes. Okay, so K is equal to J, J is initially 0. So K starting from 0 will display the content of yes, that is input. So it is ABBA dollar. Okay, so as it is, ABBA dollar is displayed. Okay, so in this way this will execute in the first iteration. After that slash n, so the next input will be on the next line, output will be on the next line. Okay, so again it will come back to the place where we have called the display function here. So after this, the end of else, again we have while loop. So again we'll come back to the beginning of while loop here. Okay, so again we have to check this condition whether stack of I is equal to yes of J. So what is I here? I is 3, J is 0. So stack of 3 is 0, 1, 2, 3. Stack of 3 is A and J is equal to 0. So this is also A. So A, both are same. So what we have to do, as we have seen here, so when these in this are same, we have to remove these. Okay. And with remaining is this one. Okay. So that's what here, in our program also we do the same thing. So when both are same, what we have to do, we have to just, we have to just discard those things. So that's why we increment the I value, decrement the I value by 1 and we increment the J value by 1. Okay. So when you decrement the I value by 1, so I becomes 2. When you increment the J value by 1, J becomes 1. Okay. So after this, here again we check this. So if stack of I equal to dollar and S of J is equal to dollar. So stack of I is 2. So stack of 2 is B. It's not equal to dollar. So S of 1 is B. This is also not equal to dollar. So this condition is false. So we'll consider the else part. In the else part, again, we check this one. That is whether the stack of I equal to dollar and S of J is not equal to dollar. So this is also not equal to dollar. So this will not be executed. So again, we'll come back to the switch statement. So again, the same lines will be executed. Okay. So the same procedure is repeated. Okay, and here already we saw how exactly this is going to discard. So to discard this, we have just decremented the value of I by 1 and incremented the value of j by 1. Okay, so in this way, the remaining part of the program will also be executed. Okay, so as a result, when you run this particular program, so you will get the same thing. And at the end, here whenever we have $, so at the end it will display the message as success. So that we'll see. So again, it will go on repeating. So when we have stack content also $ and the input content also $, will simply display the message as success. Okay. So when your program displays success, this is break means. So it will break this particular while loop, and this is the end of your particular program. So in this way, you can write a program to implement this to construct a predictive parsing table for the given grabber, and you can parse the given sentence, that is ABBA. Okay, so in this way you can write a program. Hope all of you understood this program, but still if you have any confusion or if you have not understood any part of this program, please feel free to discuss with me so that you will clarify your doubts. Okay, so now we'll run this particular program. So let us run this program now. So actually for explanation I have used the dev C++, but for execution I will use this turbo C++ here. So it's opening. So the same program we have already discussed. So now we'll directly execute this. So see, when you execute this, initially it is displaying the grammar as it is, and after that it is displaying the predictive parsing table. So it is asking enter the string. So I will enter the given string ABBA. Okay, so when I enter this, you can see it is going to display the content of stack and the content of input. Okay, so whatever the thing we have discussed, the same thing is there. So at the end you can see we have $$, and based on this $$, we have the final outcome as success. Okay, so in this way you can write a program for the same. Okay, so thank you.